This video will show you how to update your 3DS firmware offline. Yeah, you heard me, offline update. And this is only possible if you ever hacked your console previously. Are you ready for this? Let's dive in! Suppose my 3DS is on firmware 11.10, and I want to update it to the latest version. Unfortunately, I couldn't do it, because I have a terrible internet connection, or my internet service provider, even worse my country, blocked the Nintendo server, so I'm stuck at this firmware forever. Well, if you are on the same side, we can work it out as long as you ever hacked the console previously. First, read the letter at the end of the firmware version. Mine is U, which means the USA. There are other letters too. Look at your console screen and read the info on this table. Next, you need to find out your console type. Is it the new or old type? If you can see your console on the top row, then you have the old type. Otherwise, it is a new type. Then go to the Nintendo System Update Reports website. Find the link in the description. Find your console type and scroll up and down to see the target firmware. My console is a new type and I will update it to the latest firmware. At the moment, the latest firmware is 11.15, so copy the firmware text as we will need it later. Download the 3D NUS from the link in the description. And download the Sys Updater homebrew app. If you are still on the system settings, close it and turn off the console. Then remove the SD card from it. Open the 3D NUS archive and extract the content to your computer. Open the folder and run the 3dnus.exe file. Select the console type. In my case, I chose New 3DS. Remember when I told you to copy the firmware text file? You need to paste it right here. Then add the region letter behind the firmware version. In my case, I added the U letter. Press begin download. This app will create a new folder depending on the firmware version. You can see it inside the 3D NUS folder. By the way, it will take a while to download the firmware files, so please be very patient. At the end of the downloading process, you will see this pop-up notification. Press OK, then close the app. You can check the content of the newly created folder. It contains the firmware files in CIA format. Open the console's SD card content, then create a new folder and name it Updates. Drag or copy the firmware files into the Updates folder. Close the 3D NUS folder, then open the Sys Updater archive. Drag or copy the 3DS folder to the root of the SD card. Insert the SD card into the console. We will now make a NAND backup. It is mandatory because when something terrible happens, you can revive your console. Press and hold the Start button and the Power button to load GodMod 9. If you don't have it, please extract my pack in the description to your SD card. By the way, if you are prompted to make an Essentials Files backup and set up the RTC, please do so. Press the Home button, then choose Scripts. Select GM9 Megascript. Choose Backup Options. Select SysNAND Backup. And press the A button to backup the console's NAND. For your information, make sure you have at least 1.3 GB of space left on the SD card. Otherwise, you cannot proceed with backing up the NAND. press the A button to continue. Press the B button to go back, then choose Exit. Then press the Start button to boot the console. Now open the Homebrew Launcher. Select SysUpdater. Since we want to update the firmware, press the A button. Press the Y button if you are downgrading. If the target firmware is higher than the current firmware, pressing the Y button won't work. And pressing the A button won't work if the target firmware is lower than the current firmware. Then wait a while until it finishes installing the firmware. And it will auto-reboot in 10 seconds. If you cannot boot into the home screen, you might break the console. You need to load the Godmode 9 to restore the NAND. Now let's open the system settings and find out the firmware version. It is now on 11.15, so we have successfully updated the console offline using the SysUpdater. Remember, do this as a last resort if you are desperate to find a way to update your console online, since it is a bit dangerous. Thanks for watching this video. You have leveled up your modding skill once again.